Australia is entering a new phase of its COVID response. This morning, four states and one territory have redefined what it means to be a close contact. The overhaul agreed to by National Cabinet as the Prime Minister insists we have to learn to live with COVID-19.
So, what does it mean to be a close contact? Under the new definition, a close contact is someone who lives with or has spent at least 4 hours with a positive case in a household or care setting. Already, New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia and the ACT have adopted the definition. Now, if you're a positive case or deemed a close contact, you'll only be required to quarantine for 7 days and take a rapid test on day six. And you can see why our leaders thought the changes were needed when you look at the cases. Australia recorded more than 21,000 infections yesterday, which is the largest number we've seen since this pandemic began. Let's bring in Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards in Canberra to discuss these changes for us now. Good morning, Eliza. The way to isolate has now been changed.
Yes, Sarah, most of Australia is entering the new year with an entirely new way of handling COVID as cases surpassed 21,000 yesterday. From today, the required length of isolation for positive cases and close contacts is being slashed to 7 days. So if you spent more than a week in quarantine in New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia, the ACT or Queensland, you are now free to go. The change has the backing of the World Health Organisation.
We set it at 14 days initially when testing wasn't widely available because that really covered the period you're likely to be infected. But shortening is possible if you've got testing.
And there's more changes to what sort of test we should be taking. PCR tests reserved for people with symptoms. So if you're a close contact without symptoms, you should get a rapid test first. It's hoped this will free up the long testing queues, but the new rules might take a bit of getting used to. There are still plenty of cars at testing sites in Sydney this morning, although reports are the lines aren't as bad as they have been in recent weeks. Sarah?
That's a bit of a relief. Thanks, Eliza. Well, let's get more on those drastic changes to the close contact rules now. The only people required to isolate are those living with a positive case or those who've spent more than 4 hours with one. To discuss this a bit further, we're joined now by Director of the Doherty Institute, Professor Sharon Lewin in Melbourne. Sharon, good morning. What do you make of these changes?
Oh, good morning, Sarah. These changes are quite significant and they've come about because of the fact that we have a highly vaccinated population, and we now know a lot more about Omicron and its severity of disease. So finally, we have changed the rules of when to isolate, when to quarantine, and tried to make it nationally consistent. So these are important and I think welcome changes.
And I think that's key, what you mentioned there, you know, to have a nationally consistent approach to this, because there just has been so much confusion. And now we know at least that people who test positive will be allowed to leave isolation after 7 days if they get a negative test on a rapid antigen test on day six. Is that enough, do you think? Will that safeguard the community?
Yeah, I mean, our goals now have changed quite significantly. And that, as I said earlier, is because people are vaccinated. And although vaccination doesn't stop you getting infected as efficiently with Omicron as it did for Delta, it does stop you going to hospital and getting sick. And this is all about protecting our healthcare system. So many countries around the world are shortening the isolation period, combination because of the lower severity of Omicron and just how to manage these very large numbers.
And I guess because of the lower severity of this strain of the condition, the Prime Minister said that these new rules really are about helping the economy as well, getting people out of isolation so that we can keep the country running, as he says. We know that there are going to be more cases. You've just touched on that there. What kind of a surge do we actually expect?
Well, the predictions are that we will see very, very high numbers of cases, but that we are hoping, and based on what we're seeing around the world, won't lead to large numbers of hospitalisation. There will be some hospitalisation, though, so we can't take the brakes off completely here, which just means why it's important to still wear masks when you're out, why it's important that anyone eligible for their boosters should be getting them now at 4 months, because even if Omicron is much less severe, having a very large pool of people that are infected still puts pressure on our healthcare system. So the brakes can't come off completely, but it's certainly safe to relax these measures as we have done, given what we're now learning about Omicron. Mm.
And certainly, Professor Yu and the whole team at the Doherty Institute have helped guide Australia through this pandemic with the recommendations you've made over the past 2 years, including the latest in reintroducing mask wearing. Our leaders keep telling us that the health system will cope. We know that we are seeing more numbers, might not be as severe, but it still might mean that more people will be hospitalised. Can our health systems cope across the country?
Well, that's what all the planning right now is all about, and the predictions are that we can. I should also add that in other countries that have seen rapid spikes of Omicron, particularly South Africa, it's come up very quickly but also gone down quickly. Mm. So that doesn't mean that we'll have hundreds of thousands of cases for a very long time. It will be for this short period right now.
Yes, indeed, and hopefully it means that the healthcare system and also those lines at the PCR sites will also come down a little bit. Professor, thank you so much for your time and Happy New Year. Thanks for everything you've done for us.
Thanks very much. Happy New Year to you as well.